Well, good evening, everyone. I'm News 8 meteorologist Roger Griswold with you here on a Tuesday evening, tracking this storm system that continues to spread rain and snow up along the East Coast. Let's get right to some of the details, get you through the overnight hours. First, note the temperature in Portland, 11 o'clock, 34 degrees, expected to climb to 38 by 3 and up close to 40 degrees by 5 a.m. That will be the trend along the coast. Warmer air coming in on that east-southeasterly wind, which eventually will come around to more of just a pure easterly wind, driving in warm air off the warmer ocean water. In fact, you can see by 5 o'clock those wind speeds running at 13 miles per hour. That will continue to increase during the overnight, during the daytime hours, that is, on Wednesday. All right, here's what's happening. The storm system itself is down over Georgia right now would be the place to analyze it, in the center of this circulation here, and still expected to race up along the East Coast. In fact, if anything, you can see this surge of rain out ahead of it, and this surge of rain is really moving northeastward, likely to come through here at a very fast pace during the morning hours tomorrow. If anything, that means is that we may taper off to more showery weather a little bit earlier than what we had previously expected. Here are the computer models, this one having a nice handle on it, showing that by 7 o'clock this morning, heavy rain coming down, 8 o'clock in the Portland area, and you can see darker shades of orange, yellow, all indicating some downpours. And also of interest is the rain-snow line. This pink line here is now pushed well up to the north, with that center of circulation driving up through New York City and pretty much right on top of us. There is going to be this strong southerly push of warmer air right into the coastline. Midday and into the afternoon, just some waves of rain. In fact, of interest is this rain also off to our south here over Cape Cod and portions of central Connecticut. This also likely to slide northward during the afternoon. So that keeps us wet pretty much from start to finish the entire day on Wednesday. The other thing we need to be concerned about is the wind. Here is where I think the wind is going to be at its strongest. Right along the coastline, timing of this would be somewhere around, let's say 8 o'clock in the morning till 11 or 12 o'clock, especially from Casco Bay. And where the wind is going to be at its strongest? The islands and peninsulas. Closer you are to the water, you're getting hit by those east winds coming in all along York County. And not to disinclude mid-coast here, because folks there are going to be dealing with the wind as well. In fact, interior sections, Bath, Brunswick, could be dealing with some very strong winds. Note the wind speeds possibly gusting as high as 50 miles per hour along the coast. Also of note, though, is across inland areas, back here from the lakes region up through Sebago Lake, nowhere near as windy as what the coastline will be experiencing. As far as the rainfall, it's been a while since we've had a rainstorm with over 2 inches of rain. That's exactly what it looks as though will happen. New computer models tonight also indicating a couple of inches of rain. And because of that much rain, a flood watch has been issued by the National Weather Service. Good news here, 8-day forecast. A windy, turning colder on Turkey Day, Friday and Saturday, both looking